Ooh, nice play there by Swenson.
Russian.
Able to get that with a ball.
With the steal.
Great momentum there for Lacey, able to possibly take that into the fourth quarter.
And Lacey is playing with some upbeat aggression right now. This is the energy they need through this game. They pick this up to the fourth quarter, and they can go the distance.
He's like, no, I need you to go this way. I got something greater for you. Now, it might take a little longer to manifest, but I got something even sweeter. Like, I got something more fulfilling. I got something more rewarding. I got something, son, that's going to carry you for the rest of your life. Never allow life to make you forget why you started in the first place.
One of the greatest pieces of advice that my mother gave me was this. Son, whenever you start, you make sure you finish it. Every night when you look in the mirror, knowing that you gave everything you had to. And we have to get to the point where we're willing to impose our will on certain things. Impose your will on it. My life totally changed. And they gave me an opportunity to stop. And most people, when you give them an opportunity to stop while they're chasing something, they take advantage of it because they feel as if, man, why did this have to happen to me? I felt as if, why not me? This is the perfect opportunity to use this to be a blessing to somebody else. And you know what? It's not even about me, to be truthful. It's not even about me. Now it's about repaying the people that invested in me and saw something in me when I couldn't see it in myself. At a certain point in life, it can't just be about you. And the moment that we understand that, and every day we wake up, we understand that life is a blessing and life is a gift. And if you were to check out today, how would you want to be remembered? It's bigger than you. It's about learning to work from the inside out in life and not from the outside in. When you work from the inside out in life, you understand your why, you understand your how, and you understand your what.
How's it going, Jake?
So, throughout reading your story and just kind of going through it, it's been very inspiring, and there's been a lot of people I've talked to and a lot of people that care about you. So, I just want to know, can you describe for us the leading up to the sophomore season? Can you just give us the aspect of things?
I was very excited for my sophomore year. I was just very anxious. I got hurt my freshman year. I had missed most of the season. I broke a bone in my foot. So leading up to my sophomore year, I was getting ready to show out. I was working hard, and I was ready to get a name in the Shore Conference.
Could you describe the day prior to the injury?
I can absolutely describe the day prior. We were in the gym shooting around, getting ready for the season. You know, I was feeling great. I was posting dunks on social media. I was very excited, and I was pumped for the season.
When you went down, can you just describe the atmosphere of what was happening?
You know, it was crazy. I made a hit, and I whipped around, and I like heard a huge crack like go through my body, and I was like, I think I just broke my leg. And I looked down, and my leg's like dangling there. I was like, oh my God. I threw off my helmet, and Coach Smith came running to me, and he was just telling me stuff. He's like, there's two ways you can go with this. He's like, you can either come back better than ever or just run away from everything.
What was going through your mind when you were on the ground?
Extreme frustration. I was so angry, you know, just so annoyed. I threw my helmet off. I was so frustrated because I knew it. Like, it wasn't like, no, there was no hiding it. My leg was almost out of my skin. So I was like, it was just crazy.
So after the injury, and you're starting to recover now, did you ever think you would bounce back from this?
I did. In the hospital, you know, the first thing I was saying to my father, my mother, and my coaches, I'm like, I'm coming back better than ever from this. Like, no question in my mind, I'm gonna bounce back from this.
What was your mindset like throughout this the recovery time?
You know, I always had a positive mindset. The first 2 months were tough, because I had a cast all the way to my groin. There was no mobility at all. My legs just became twigs. I lost like 35 pounds. So that was no fun, but I always just stayed mentally strong, just had perspective, and, you know, fought through it.
This has been such a devastating injury, and you've bounced back from it. How has this shaped you as a person?
It's probably the best thing that's ever happened to me, because it showed me perspective on life and what hard work does. Because, you know, my grandmother got paralyzed when she was 50 with 4 kids, and she couldn't walk the rest of her life. I couldn't walk for 2 months, you know. So that gave me perspective, and that helped me a lot and gave me a positive attitude for it. And so that definitely taught me a lot, and was probably was the best thing that's ever happened to me.
Missing your entire basketball season, and you're such a big part. I watched your games this year, and you've got Instagram Sports Center on there too. What was it like, just the feeling of watching and not missing that season?
You know, definitely, it was no fun. I'm watching my teammates, knowing I could help them out, and just not being able to be out there and playing, doing something that I love to do. It definitely hurt me a little bit, but like I said, having perspective, knowing I was going to come back and do, we were going to be just fine when I came back.
Jake, when Carl was hurt, I happened to be at the football game in 2016, one of those fall evenings. We were at Manchester High School. So not only was I told about it, but I was there, and I saw Carl on the field. I saw his leg. I saw people tending to him, and I saw him in excruciating pain, but being composed as best he could be under the circumstances.
During the time of the injury, it was a defensive play against Manchester. It was kind of a bang-bang play. It happened quickly, but you can tell by the reaction of his teammates and the other team that it was serious.
We saw them kind of running away and not knowing what to say. So as myself and Coach Smith approached approached Carl when he was down, we knew that it was serious just by seeing his leg, and we knew how serious it actually was. We talked him through it. We were trying to tell him not to look at his leg, kind of kept him pinned down a little bit so he couldn't look at the leg. I think the hardest part of the whole situation was actually talking to his mother and explaining to his mom how bad the injury was.
But he bounced back fairly quickly, and it looks like he hasn't lost a step at all.
I accompanied him to the hospital with his parents. We were at the hospital for quite a few hours trying to make some executive decisions on how we wanted to, well, really his parents wanted to handle the medical needs necessarily moving forward. So we met with doctors. We conferred about decisions that had to be made, and I got very close to the Swenson family at that time. So when I found out about it, I knew a lot about it, and I knew that he was going through a long haul to get fixed, because it was very clear that his leg was seriously displaced. So basically, I followed the path of his recovery to the incredible amount of time that he spent rehabbing, being immobile, not being able to come to school. I mean, there were so many factors that were a big part of that injury. To see him participating and walking today and being happy as a lark, to be a part of this school community is really incredible.
Leading into Carl's sophomore year, I knew he was a pretty good athlete. He played football as a younger kid, took off his freshman year.
You know, when we first heard about the injury, at the time I was actually the assistant coach, and the head coach texted me and kind of let me know the news. And this was, you know, right before basketball season's about to ramp up, and it was devastating.
I was excited for him to come out and, you know, perform for us like he did. He came out for us, you know, got into the mix right away as a sophomore and contributed, and by the end of the year, with one of our starting receivers. And he ended up starting on defense, too.
Going into that year, he was going to be a sophomore at the time, and we were kind of leaning on him for a lot of the ball handling responsibilities in the upcoming season, and we were going to lean on him a little bit, and we lost it abruptly, and it hurt.
So that injury didn't only affect Carl and his family, but I think it was far-reaching, because I emotionally saw what was going on and was moved by the whole experience. The fact that his football team was there and his brother football players, because it is that kind of a family unit, gathered around him, wished him well. So the impact is that everybody knows when somebody gets hurt, you know, the implications are you lose that kid for a period of time off of your team. And in Carl's case, I mean, he's basically been done with football.
You know, this year as a junior, we definitely could have used him on both sides of the ball. But like I said, basketball is his first sport, so I didn't want to push him to come out and play and, you know, re-hurt himself. And I wanted him to enjoy his junior year in basketball, which ended up being good for him. You know, he averaged 20-plus points a game.
So I think it was catastrophic, but I also think it showed people great courage that he fought through some serious adversity, and he was able to rehab himself, both mentally and physically, back into being the young man that he was before that injury. Additionally, he was a basketball player. And so going into his sophomore season as a potential varsity basketball player, and that's his real passion as I understand it, it was devastating. So I think the impact was just that he proved to his peers that he could work through adversity like no other 15 or 16 or 17-year-old young man that I've known in my life.
It affected the team in a few different ways. You know, from a leadership standpoint, he's kind of the guy that's more of a vocal guy that'll step up and, you know, put people in their place if he has to, or, you know, give a good job if he has to. He's more of a vocal guy. So when we lost that, it was tough, you know. And on top of that, the ball handling responsibilities, which is, you know, such a big part of the game, is getting the ball up and down the court and getting in the sets and, you know, kind of controlling the pace of the game. So that affected us in a big way.
I found him to be courageous. I found him to be very strong-willed. And I know that he worked very, very hard to recover and to be able to be in athletics again 15, 16, 17 months after such a devastating injury.
Well, you know, that was probably the coolest part about this whole thing. So when this all went down, you know, it's traumatic and it's scary and, you know, it's depressing and all these things, but the rehabilitation from this and how far he's come from it is really something special. You know, I've been around sports a long time, been around a lot of players, played with a lot of kids, coached a lot of kids, and seen a lot of injuries, you know, and injuries, you go one way or the other coming back, and, you know, you can kind of just fade off and say, you know what, maybe this is not meant for me, or you can kind of put your head down and grind and try to work to get back to that level. Now, that being said, it's hard to do, and it's hard to get back to that level, and, you know, to see a guy like Carl get to that level and then kind of surpass where he even was, it's pretty special.
He took the injury and he turned it around to make it a positive experience for himself. He was laid up for a good period of time. His buddies came to see him, so he was never out of communication with the school community. I know that when he was able to get around, he came into school sporadically, and he tried to do some things that he could do here temporarily. I just know that he has endured a lot of things for a young man, and he has worked through some adversity that not everybody would be able to do at his age. The bottom line is Carl is a better person for the experience. I think he appreciates his life. He appreciates the ability to play athletics at a high level of performance, and that this will absolutely help him in his life when he's hitting a roadblock in his career, in his personal life, in his social life, and even in the rest of his high school career. He knows he has the strength and the will to work past any adversity. And to me, I think he's proven that in his steps from being a sophomore to now, and the improvements he has made, tremendous. He has a tremendous will to work through adversity, and I admire him on many fronts.
You know, and on top of that, to have all that rehab and everything, that's great, but to actually see it on the court and get to see all that hard work, you know, in play was really cool. And he actually, you know, he took advantage of the opportunity after missing a full year his sophomore year. He came back this year, his junior season, and he was third, I believe, in the shore in scoring at 20.9 points a game, so just under 21 points a game. So you can really see how that all that hard work paid off.
People that want to know, would you call us a comeback?
I probably would, because starting, they didn't know if I was going to be able to play sports again, and then, you know, to come back the way I did, I would call it a comeback.
After talking to so many people, it's just everything you've given me is just it's becoming more and more inspiring to me. And there's so many people that care about you. Everybody I've talked to, it's just been amazing. So thank you, Carl.
No problem, Jake. Thank you. A king is born.